Hello and welcome to GoPanda. Today we got a 10k versus 10k. I am black. Coordinates. Whoa, now this thing's down. You know how the scroll bar was moving? Now that thing moved down. Weird. So this is inviting me to take this side. If I do something like this, or just I'm playing over here, that's for sure. The question is, do I do opposing and then approach, or opposing, let him, and then take another corner? I have a feeling if I do opposing, he's going to approach. So if I do start of a Kobayashi Chinese looking thing, and then say approach high and develop the side. So I'm going to get the first approach. Yeah, let's do that. So if you didn't watch the end of the Casado video, I apologize for no game on Wednesday. Last week and then 2 weeks before, 2 weeks before that was the Cogners. But the week before last, I only had enough time to really record a week's worth, and last weekend was completely shot, so all of the videos that are coming up, or going up this week, I guess this one's coming out Friday. All the videos that came out this week were recorded the day before, with the exception of this one. This one is actually recorded on Wednesday. So, I don't know what to think about this. I want to approach high, though, because I want to develop this. Versus low. My guess? Well, let's see. I could also approach a little further away and then actually set up a Kobayashi. From here, if he takes this, then I can back off here, but then it's low, low, low. I don't really like that. So I'm going to shoot for high. If he does the usual approach underneath, I'll end up extending further with the open tiger's mouth and then approaching here, which turns out... it's a little inefficient... yeah, let's do it. We'll see what he does. Alright, so he does approach. Alright, cool. I'll just stick to the usual Joseki here. We got this move, and then I can jump over to here. Technically, more efficient would be to do this connection and then here, because then it's a 5 space. But I'm gonna look to close that gap with a move like this. And then approach here, giving him sente, of course, which he'll probably use to enclose. You are taking that immediately. That's good later when you have a stone here. Now I can let him connect, and instead attach here. I think this is the move to punish this, right? Attach. Because if he throws in, I can cut. Atari, fix. Atari, and ladder to there. I think this is the move to punish that. If he does decide to link up, great. I can let him link up, and then approach over here for a similar effect. So, yeah. Anyways, he should have come here, let us finish, take Sende to make an enclosure or approach. Alright, if I throw in, there's Atari, and fix, or I can just pull back. Or I can go here. Crawling would be good for me. Although, Atari... looking at this, because if he Ataris this and then connects, I can Atari in here, or actually, hold on. Yeah, I suppose I can Atari here, make a group. Now this one be kind of free-floating, immediately comes under attack. I don't particularly like that. What's the move? To expose this, and then he comes around. Although I can then take the corner and then... See, if he fixes, then I can Hani because Atari, this forces that. I can go here. He has three liberties to my three liberties. He can take on with this. I can. Well, then I'm screwed then, aren't I? If I just crawl, and he crawls, and then I can come back. It seems really. I don't like that. I'd have to Hane, and then if he cuts, I can. Well, hold on. If I do this, he does this. I can Hane then, right? Because if he tries coming in here, then I can cut. And if he cuts, I Atari. He can Atari. This comes. That's Atari then. Then I can Atari this. He captures. What's the move? Atari. Connect. Cut. Capture. And then he needs to fix or connect underneath, right? Or he'll probably, well, if he connects underneath, I can give these up, I guess. So I'm thinking he's going to do this Atari. So if I just pull back, what does he do? Does he go here? And then do I chase it? I'm using a lot of time on this move, I know. Like I said, he's going to do this cut. Can I cut here? What would we do? Would he capture and then I fix? Oh, you know what? I could do that. If he captures, then I can... Wait. Atari, cut. Capture, cut. Atari... That's Atari again. Running out of time. I have to play a move. Oh, he fixes. Whoa, that's lovely. Do I do this one then? Because then it kind of reverts, right? Atari. No, I should probably just do this. Or this. This. Or ignore it. I don't need it, do I? I could pincer this. I could also just fix. My defects are fine. I'm just going to fix. Alright, so you're connecting underneath, and I'm okay with that, actually. Because normally when he approaches here, the move is here to block it, if I have a stone here, but I don't. Which means if I block, he can just extend over here, make a base, and that sort of thing. So, I am going to use this to... approach this way and use the influence that I just got, or try to. He's going to try and break up the influence. This would push it towards his wall, which is kind of ill-advised, actually. And if he doesn't, then I can pincer this, or even attack it. Attack it towards there. Because I want to push it towards Stictus, right? Which is probably why he went there, because then he can feel like he can make a base. However, now I can get some serious moves on this sort of thing. Is this cut now a problem? It kind of is. This isn't really that strong. There is this cut, which... If I throw in here and he goes here, well, I need to fix here first if I do that. This move helps with that and also starts attacking this sort of stuff. So let's... This feels like the wrong direction, but I think these are weaker than I was originally expecting. So, alright, so you're doing that. What if I attach underneath? I can settle quickly. Let's see, he can... Honey. I will... going to pull back a little bit. Because this base right now is undercut by this stone here. So I can throw in here and completely destroy this. So these stones are really weak and I need to get an attack on them. So you're descending there. I can actually go here as a clamp and attack this some more. My stones are also undercut. If he goes here, I can Atari. I think on this one I'm going to extend rather than do anything else. Because this is getting nice thickness now. And then I can come back and attack this. So now these stones are looking pretty weak. Uh-huh. And I need to... Hane. And so that means he can extend here. Now, I think I need to... Can I go here? Yes. I'm strong. So I'm going to follow. This is like the head of two stones with this stuff. You're honeying again. Okay, so that's kind of interesting. I can go... Wait a minute. How do I attack this? Can I do this? I'm strong enough to do this. I want to push it here. He'll have to go again, and then he's going to honey again. Can we do this crawling thing, and I'd get all of the sickness? Do I care? I have a lot of thickness then, and I can... This seems really bad. Can I cut here? Atari. Cover. Atari? I wanna... Well, this means he can jump there. And then can I cut? Because I have this stone here. Because if I have to run there... Okay. This sets up the cut. Alright, now the cut's basically gone. So if I poke in here, this eliminates one eye, and then he has to get another eye over here, but I first need to seal it in with a move like this. If he hanes, I can Atari, and then ladder, which means that he can cut... So now I'm going to hane. So if he ends up taking this sort of move... Oh, he's... Okay, that's fine. Do I care if he pokes through? A little bit. Okay. Six seconds a move. I unfortunately had to play. So now he's making live shape. That's fine. I will now take... I should probably fix my defects, shouldn't I? Or I can make an enclosure. I'm gonna make an enclosure. There is cutting points and stuff, but I don't think I can attack this group anymore. So you're going there, okay. Two seconds of stone, which kind of sucks. Now I can... So I'm going to kick this because it's kind of over-concentrated. Force him to respond. And then I can get this extension. And then we can sort of revert to something that we had before. But you're not going to do that. So since you didn't do that, I'm going to do this. There isn't a whole lot of thinking here. I apologize if these are terrible moves. Oh, shoot. Ah. All right, I'm playing another game. That does not count. Okay, so we're going to do a second game because that one was... Very frustrating. It's 10k versus 10k. I am black again. I gotta put coordinates on. Go for Orthodox now. Oh, yay, yay. Are we doing mirror go? Nope. Cool. So, I mean, if we do this sort of variation, it ends up me getting stuff here. And he's really trying to develop this side anyways. Let's... I'm kind of curious to see if I should approach high first. Settle this and get some sort of thing and then deal with this. Yeah, okay, let's do that. set this up again. Hopefully this one finishes the Joseki. Okay, good. Your approach, you went that way, huh? Interesting. I can put some pressure on it by approaching here. I don't think I'm going to, though. I am going to instead break up white's... No, wait. Okay, so I think that's a really slow move. So what I need to do is take some large extensions like this. This is a smaller extension. If he comes in here, he's going to be under attack immediately. My instinct is either to approach. This seems greedy. because then it also destroys my potential to build over here. Sorry, there's a cat in the background. Although with this stone here, I really can't build that high anyways. Now, if I had a double wing forming, then I would be more inclined to approach. So, I think I'm going to approach from this side. Go into more of a territorial type game then, I guess? Well, wait. Yeah, because unless I lean on this some, this is not going to get very big anymore. So I'm going to approach here. I won't be resigned. Okay, well, that offsets the game that I... Alright, so this is the third game, 10k versus 10k plus. I am black again. The odds of that happening on, well, because they were all even games, the odds of that happening are 1 in 8, if you're wondering. So toggle coordinates again. Okay, wait a minute, is this the same guy? I wonder if it is. Anyways, so let's try for a similar approach, I guess. Yeah, it's pretty much setting up the same game that we just did. However, I am going to take an enclosure this time. No, well, is this the same guy? I do not remember. So you took a large extension depriving me of my thing, so... well, now it's a crapshoot, isn't it? If I approach it, well, it's... I can do this and then set up a double wing. Because this means he's going to back off, probably. Let's see, if I approach here, he can do some... This invokes a response, and then I can get this sort of thing. This seems really small, though. Guys. Very strange moves. So, he's going to settle here. If I build this up, or should I build this one up? This one would help with this developing stone. It's still invadable, of course. Either way, I'm going to feel cramped, unfortunately. I think this one has more room to develop. Alternatively, well, let's see. His plan's probably going to cut. And then I need to extend. I want to... Which side's better? If he cuts here and I extend, he extends, and I Atari and connect, And then he captured these stones on the fourth line. He's developing here, which kind of limits his potential. If I do it the other way and extend this one again, if he extends and I can Atari and do a similar thing, that actually develops better with this one. So let's do that. If his plan is to crosscut, I should have read something else instead of just the crosscut. So he is going to go there. So then it's like he went here, I shoulder hit, and then, I don't know. Interesting. If he cuts, I can do this move, because then if he does this, okay. I wonder if he's just going to extend. Okay, if he extends, then I can do this and push him some more. If he pushes up, what do I do? This, because if I go here, he can jump, right? Wedge. I'm kind of worried. Well, why am I worried about this cut? If he turns, then I can jump. If he cuts, I can Atari and go here. This doesn't work, because that's just Atari dead. So I'm going to go here. Get him on the attack. That is fine. Although, okay. The stone's reinforcing that, so I can ladder it if I need to. You're just trying to make life here, huh? See, so yeah, I can Hane, and I can, well, we can do this. And it still has access to the outside, so. Boy, making life, huh? Okay, well, in that case, I am going to use this giant wall of influence and try to build on it. Now, this capping move, I mean, he can easily poke through. Capping move is not very good right now. There is still some potential to invade in here. Either high or low. Low means I can do some wedging stuffs. But it's too early to invade. I need to use this wall and extend from it. And I want to extend all the way over here. A high move, I think. So again, I'm not going to try to kill this. I pretty much profited enough by it. I don't want to settle with this one. I actually want to build outside influence. Actually, I probably... You think I should have attached there? What is that doing? Which one's better? This one invokes a response. This one, if he goes there, I don't have to respond then. I can start jumping and shoulder hitting and stuff like that if I do this one instead. He also can attach here. Then I can Hane. And if he descends, then I can also extend. Start developing all of this. I think I'm going to do this one. Oh, wait, no, I want to do the other one. Shoot. Well, okay, this is fine. That's not what I wanted to do. I wanted to do the other one. This is threatening to push through and cut, so that's where that is. This is... Yeah, anyways. This is undercut over here, so what I want to do now is... I can do this. And then I can do this, and then do this, then there's this cut, and this cut. Looking to kill this again, huh? So there is some invasions in here. This is not by any means secure or my territory yet. It's just threatening to be. Now I have this. I really should take... If I can get him to crawl... odds are if I go here, he's going to Hane. I don't want to do that. I want... to invade, right? Well, now that stone's there, this is kind of hard to invade. Although, what if I just go here first? Give him all of this influence? Am I okay with that? I can... Oh, you know what? Rush invasion. I know I overuse it, but if I go here, I can jump here, give him up this stuff, and then cut through all this and build a nice... get all of this and reduce this a little bit as well. So I'm going to do this. I haven't figured out how to use this stuff yet, but this seems pretty important for him to respond to. Well, that's interesting. He's gonna let me live directly, and then I can jump over here anyways and get both? No way, man. Which one do I want more? I kind of want this one more. What does he do though? If he goes here, I can go this, and then I can actually cut. I'm surprised he didn't attach on top. All right, just gonna butt into it and cut. And Atari. And capture, make sure, okay, capture reduces Aji, so I'm gonna do that. There is this cutting point now behind. He can Atari, but I'm not gonna respond to it. So he's defending this stuff. I can go, yeah, I can't go there. I can do this though. I can push and do this. But I'm pretty much giving up that stone. I don't particularly like that. I can Hani here. He'll probably just extend and I'll extend with him. And then I'm building up all this while he's building this. So what about going here to expose the cut? Go here to expose the cut, settle quickly, and then go back to building. I kind of like that. Let's try that. He can obviously pincer me here, but then I can push and cut. Alright, so he's defending there, so I will take an extension over here. And now he is coming into my middle, but I'm not really trying to... this is Sente, that exposes the cut. I can also push and cut. But I think I'd rather just take the extension. This is a little close. This would secure the thing. And although, well, no, because he's just going to do this. So maybe I should do this first and then expose the cut. Right? Although then there's this move in Sente. This is pretty much going to be a Sente move for him no matter what. And if he gets some sort of... this would force him to capture, or this would force him to connect, and then I could make this sort of move, I guess, and start building this. This is the shape point for the eye, of course. This push and threaten to cut, and then this is just free to roam. I don't like that. What if I go here? This, that. I don't like that. I don't like that at all. You know, I think I'm willing to give those up if he wants to cut, to be honest. And so what I want to do is make some large extensions. Because we're not really to the point of building in the middle yet. In fact, I probably should not have invaded yet. That's kind of a improper opening theory. In this one, I can either choose to let him live on the side, which I think I will do, because I've already got the extension here, which means I can actually do, when he jumps here, I can do this one and then chase him. And while I chase him, this gets sealed in, although I really can't attack it very much. But I want to do this first. So he'll go here, which means I can take this move. And then he'll jump, or should I? I don't want him to jump there, so I'd rather him jump here, and then I can get a capping move like this. And then once I get enough stuff here, then I can start leaning on this thing, get a couple capping moves, whatever, and then try to develop all this. So that's my plan right now. So let's do that. This is now kind of becoming a cramped corner if this ever comes out, which is why I'm going to be attacking from this way. With a move like this. And then I can actually cut through here, can't I? So I like... This is, you know, fine. Capping move, not really a fan of, actually. I think I would rather do this. Push him towards this a little bit. Because, again, the... Well... Because Because this is coming from the top, this is coming from the bottom. This pushes him this way, and I can get a couple jumping moves, and then I can start capping this stuff. That's what I want to do. So let's do this. I see a kitten trying to make mischief behind my monitor. So you're securing your group. Oh, please don't like that. So I am going to seal him in then, right? I can do that. This cut is actually a problem. If I do that and then this, I can seal him in, right? This fixes the cut. Okay. Now I'm really solid. You're solid in the corner. I can poke at this, and you do that. I can actually get this move, and and then you have two eyes, right? Or do you? I don't know, sir. I don't. No, I can't cut directly, but I can poke at this. And then if I go here, you have this. And then I can actually descend here in Sente. And then, like, this threatens that, so I think, or can I go deeper yet? Can I do this? Bump-a-dump-a-dump. Nope. Can I do this? This, that. Wait. This, that. You'd have to do this. I could do this. If I do this, then you connect and you're alive. So I'd need this, which means you can do this. And then this would get rid of the one eye. So, I don't think I succeeded in attacking this. Because if I do this, that, this, that, this. Like, this looks like a starting move. But first I would need to seal it in. Although I can't, I think it's fine. I can't really attack it, can I? Like, if I do this, this would threaten the corner, so he'd probably respond, and then I would need to respond, so that's Gotei. This starts to build some stuff. It also kind of prevents him from running. I think this one might work better, though. Let's see, you can diagonal and Hane Tari capture. So this effectively seals it in. Is my cutting points. I'm fine. Okay, so let's do this. If he comes back to defend, great. Because then I can threaten something like this and then basically claim all this to myself. Give up this little points in the corner. Because there is still odd you with that. I am not going to respond to that. So not you're sealed in, but you think you're fine, right? If I descend here, I can still descend. I can descend here in Sente. I can cut. Can I cut? No, because that's just alive. Okay. So you're looking to invade here. If I cut, and you extend, and I do this, I can effectively get all that because I can... Okay, hold on. Because if you cut here, then I'll just defend here, and I'm fine. If I go here and you extend, then I can do this one, and this one, and this one, and then just seal it all in. I'd be very happy with that. As it stands, I can mess with this too, can't I? Because there's this. Like, if I get this, that, you'd need to go here. If I get this, you'd need to fix. So these are MI for life for him. I can do this one, which means you'll connect here. I think I'd rather get this that though. How about this? Again, if he captures, I can do that. If he goes here, then I can still defend. There is a cut. I can extend, cut, extend. I think I'm going to do this. Make boxes. If he pushes, I can Atari, force him to capture. And you're going to fix there. Cool, which means that I will extend myself. Because this group is here, this wall is pretty much useless. So now you can push and cut, but there really isn't anything there. I can push and cut you off. And then this thing's floating in midair? Are you sure about that? Are you sure you want to do that? Because now you're helping me seal you in. And then this thing I can now chase. So start running. Wedging here, I can, not wedging, turning, I can follow it once, but again, it's, oh, you're not gonna do that. I'm actually okay with that, because again, it's, this could become in trouble, actually no, because I still have this push and this wedge, so I'm gonna do that right now, actually. He's not going to do that. Interesting. So if I do that, he can come back and cut. However, now I can do this myself and cut this stone off. But this isn't as big. So this might have been a mistake on my part. He can Atari this, of course. I can save the two stones, or I can extend and just let him have them. Although, Atari, extend, I can cut this stone off at least. So that might have been a mistake. This means he just captures and has a Panuki in the middle of the board. He can still cut, so I need to defend if I want to save those stones, but they're not big enough. I think I'd rather get this. If he follows me, then I will connect. Yeah, I'm regretting this. But I think I need to now, don't I? What about extending here and just kind of following it and then connecting? Like, I can get this. This is all connected. I'm not worried about this at all. I can turn here. I can jump here. I can build this up fairly well. Hey, you, stop it. Getting a Panuki in the middle of the board is pretty big. However, if I fully surround these, could I set up some sort of shortage? Am I really going to bank on that? Oh dear. This means I have to come back and fix. This actually takes a liberty off of that. If he pushes here, I'd have to fix, and then he could do that, so that would not be a good fix. This would be a decent one. He can throw in and do something like that, but this forces that, or he just captures probably. Now, this group still only has one eye, however, and it's in the middle of the board. So I am going to attack it some more. I am going to save these cutting stones, because I think they're important, because now these are still floating, and he owes me a move. So that means I can get this one now. And now I need to separate this from this, which is what I'm doing effectively there. Man, you're just going everywhere, aren't you? Let's see. If I do this and he cuts, I can connect. If he cuts here, I can Atari this way and do this. So I am going to attack you. He's making weak croups all over the board. Right now, his only territory is here. Can I honey? If he cuts, I can... let's see, then there's this Atari. Do I just... Well, actually, I think I can pull back and then honey, right? Okay. My group is strong. The stone itself is weak, though. This is also... Well... What if I just go here? What can you do? If you push, I block. If you Atari, I extend. If you Atari, I extend. I think I can go here. Because if it goes here, you can't ladder it. You can't net it. If he nets it, okay, that's interesting. It's going to revert, though. Okay, so you're pushing into my territory, that's fine, but now I can cut, right? Now you're fixing, okay. So now you're effectively in my territory. This cut is kind of a problem now, I guess. So that was not really good for me. However, this still doesn't have eyes, right? So I can still do things like this and attack it somewhere. So I'll just block. Okay. And then there's this Atari, of course. If you go again, then I can Atari and kill you, so that's not a good thing. I don't think that's a good move. Because then I can... Well, then you have this cup that I can just capture, so... This ladder's into there. You knew I was going to do that. You're working at this cut, right? And then I... Well, this stuff is alive, so I don't care. If I just capture and you... Well, if you Atari, I ignore it. So I'll just capture. I don't care. If you cut, go ahead. I'll save the one stone. Or I'll save the two stones here, because then there's this Atari. Actually, if I pull back here, there's still this cut. But then I lose all... I lose all hope of actually attacking this. If you cut here, well, this kind of sucks. This saves a few, this saves about 4 points here. This gives him about 5 points. So, if I pull back here, he has to cut here. And then there's some push and cut stuff. But I can still come back to attack this, I guess. Although, I have to disconnect this from that, otherwise he just connects out to this stuff. Unless I do this, and then cut. Because that makes that a false eye. This is all eyes, anyways. Debating, which one should I pull back? This one? And then let him cut? And then push here? Yeah, I can't do anything about that. Well, coming down to points, let's see, this I can get for free and make some eye shape and pull back here if I need to. This, again, I think I'm going to just... I'm going to pull this one back. Okay, so you can now cut and connect. I've now basically secured this entire thing. That's good. There's still oddity with this stuff, so it's not entirely yours yet. If I connect here, then there's a cutting problem for you. A big cutting problem for you. You're going to let me save them? Let's see, if you cut... Oh, you're reducing my eye space. I see. So if I go here, you can't cut, right? You can Atari. then I can Atari and Atari. I think I would, well, actually, this prevents him from doing that, and it also gets me to the outside more. He'd have to come back first, and then I could connect. Or I can just do this directly, and then if he cuts, I can Atari, so I will just do this. Makes empty triangle, terrible shape, I know. Now the next question, do I have enough for two eyes? I can get a couple free forcing moves, like I can get this one, and then I can get this one. Okay, you fixed the one, I'm going to take this one now. Alright, so now you're definitely alive in the corner. I can cut here and get my second eye. Can I get two eyes elsewhere? If you wedge in here, no, if you go here I can do this. If you go here, I can do this, and then you can poke in here. So I do need to cut this stone off in order to get the eye. What about this wedge, though? Aha, you're pretty good, sir. Capture. So this is a false eye now. However, I can poke through. And cut. And then you have to come back and capture this. If you do that, then I can Hani here. Or actually, I can take this one. And then if you go there, I can do this and get... Oh, man. If I descend here, I for sure have one eye here. And then if you poke up here, I can do this. And then if you poke, I can... If I descend here, I can push and then take this, forcing you to do that. And then I can do this. Looks like pushing through and cutting is my choice, which means he can just Atari and run with it or try to. He's running short on liberties pretty quickly, though. But I need to do this now for sure. These stones are in danger. Cutting here. This actually doesn't help me with my liberty, so he should be able to just come back and cut. He doesn't even need to fight. Meanwhile, I can use this to get into here. Now, this is a very precarious situation. Okay, you are going to cut that off right away. Now, can I make a second eye? It could come down to a capturing race between these two groups. Let's see, I can Atari this, so it should save it, so he'd need to respond. Let's see, and you have one eye, so then I would need to fix... Because basically I have one eye. Actually, if I do this, don't I have two eyes? If he wedges, if he goes here, I can just do this. If he goes here, I can do this. No, I only have one eye. Okay. Really? Even if I do this? Because that would force this. And then when I go here, he'd just poke in here. Okay, so it is only one eye. So I need to fight to get rid of this stuff. And then disconnect it from this. Basically, I have two ways of disconnecting this. I can go here, and I can go here, and then have to kill it alt-right. With this, he can cut, and he can cut through here, and I would just connect. See if it cuts directly, and then he can push. So I think I need to do... Or I could just be a solid move and have no Aji. This keeps ahead of it, though. This is a key point. If he cuts, and hanes, and nets, although, will he connect here? What's the move? Is it this one? I'm gonna go with that one. Yeah, now I can disconnect you from here. And now you gotta try to run to this stuff, basically. there is a lot of free forcing moves. Like this is a free forcing move, for instance. Probably want to take it right away. So now he needs to make two eyes because he only has a couple himself. Does that work? I think I'm just going to do this. There's also this elephant's eye jump here. That's kind of protecting the cutting point. However, poking here and then going here. Like there is this poking point thing. This pretty much gets rid of that though. Any one of these. This doesn't look too bad. Although then I can't do this one, so I might want to do this one now. So I'm just gonna play patiently. Hopefully he doesn't start the capturing ice right away. It might, well, this go to that and then that. Yeah, you're taking that. That's good. This removes a liberty. You can also set up some squeeze and get a shape, so I don't really want you to do that. I can poke through. If I do this, there's a throw-in, and then you can make shape immediately. So I'm going to avoid that by playing here. So you're making more shape. I can Atari and go here, and then you can Atari that and make some more shape. So basically, you're trying to make life here to prevent me from getting this alive. If I Atari and go here... Actually, Andy, I would need to Atari and go here. Because I think you're going to want to protect that. Or you're going to fight a big co for this, which... Not sure if you want to do... Because he can't cut. He can poke at cutting, but I can poke in here myself. And this is just to eliminate the rest of the eyes. Now, this can be poked from either side. So there isn't any eyes. I can go here. And then I can poke here. Because then I have either one of these moves to block that eye. If he blocks this way, I can poke here. That's actually just helping him, so I'd rather do this then. If he blocks here, I'd rather do this. Because if he blocks here, then I can go here and go here. If he blocks, then I can cut and... that doesn't quite work, does it? Alright, so you are going to block that way. If you go here, then the move here is just that. Likewise with either one. Cutting and that. I have to be wary of that. Let's see. So we have hitting the head on the nose here. If he blocks here, I can pull this out here. If he blocks here, I can go here. And then poke and Atari, dead, right? To be honest, I think he probably should start the capturing race. Okay, so you're blocking there, which means I can go here and cut. If he tries playing this out, I can Hane and connect. If he tries blocking here, I can just cut, and then these are all dead. A lot more interesting game than the first one. The first one was just crazy. Alright, so you're blocking here. Now this cut is a problem, and so I need to do a move like this to protect it. This also helps with him jumping here and getting more liberties. He can push, but that's about it. So that's a good sentai move. Again, if he blocks here, I'll just do this because he can't come out. Oh boy. Meanwhile, he's losing liberties pretty quickly. Does that mean he can do this now and then cut an Atari? I think it does. So in order to prevent that, I'm going to take a liberty off of this thing. Because then I can poke in here, and then he can't Atari. If he goes here, then I can do that, of course. So I am going to remove that Aji with this move. Okay, yeah, good, 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 good. So now you're going to go back to running. And I should be able to just push you right into that, right? Can you Hane? No, because I can cut. So I'll just push. Heart's racing. Alright, so you are going to start the capturing race then. Well, I have a lot of forcing moves, like poking here, for instance, is a pretty big one. However, making this, that, this, going here is a big sente move. It also reduces your liberties. I could also just do this and this, but I'd rather reduce from the outside. So this actually reduces two of your liberties. Now, I can't take this last one until everything else is an Atari. How many liberties do I have? I have a false eye here. Basically, I have not a whole lot. Wedging here, I need to reduce the main group, so I need to disconnect it. If he goes, if he Ataris and then connects, and then I can cut and connect. But I need to remove liberties from this big thing. So I'm going to start with this. Looks like I need to do this, though. Forcing this, and then I'm down to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 liberties. If I don't do that, and he goes here and pushes, then I'm dead. I have to connect here anyways. This goes to that. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 liberties again. So no matter what I do, I have 6 liberties. So let's do this. This is a bamboo joint, so it's not really a liberty. He can do this and poke here, of course. So what if I just do this, though? Because then I can poke up here and do this. I think I might cut. Capture. There's this Atari and go here, but then I can cut. And then he can connect. I think I'm going to leave that alone because I can poke here yet. But then I need to come back, so I probably wouldn't do that actually. If he comes here, I can cut. Actually, no, if he comes here, I'm screwed now. So I actually need to deal with this first and then come back already or cut it off right now. Cutting it off also takes a liberty, so I'm going to do that as well. If he goes here, then I need to go here, or go here. If he goes here, then I can do that. If he goes here, I'm screwed, so I can't do that, can I? But I need to take this and then that. This forces that, and then I can do this. Or should I block here? Because then, well, he's going to connect. What happens if I do this? If he goes here, I need to do this now. Otherwise, I'm going to lose all of that. So the question is, even if I lose all that, is it going to be enough? Or do I have enough to live? Like, I could cut up some stuff here, and my points are here, a little bit here. There's not really much in the center anymore. With him getting that, I'm going to be hard-pressed, I think. I do have a few sente moves, like this, and this is a sente move. So if there's some sort of cold threat, I can actually pull here. That's a pretty big threat. However, I just thought of something. So long as I have one eye, and I can prevent him from getting an eye, well, it's going to be tricky. If I can get him down to one eye and one liberty, that means he can never Atari this without self-Atari. And that's kind of where it's going. But if he has a lot of liberties, like 5 or 10 liberties, then he can connect here and do this no problem. So right now, this is one liberty. He's got one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If he connects now, he's effectively got 7, 8, 9, 10. I mean, he has a lot of liberties, don't get me wrong. So he should be able to win this outright. I'm not sure what he's doing. Very, very, very exciting. I know I say that as I'm sighing, but... So I'm wondering if this wasn't the right choice then. Saving that? Well, no, because now I still have this move in Sente, of course. At any time. I have one eye and a false eye. If I play here, he goes here. And then I need to connect, and then he can go here. Can I do anything with this? No, he has way too many. He has five in a row now. I think you're ahead, sir. I think you're going to be able to win this capturing race, no problem. However, there might be some interesting things with this. For instance, if I go here, then this is an eye. So this group is alive. I mean, it was alive before, but... if I go here, you can go there, I can do this, you can do that, I can do this, and you can actually get me rid of an eye. If I go here, then I can get an eye. But those liberties get down pretty quick, because there's actually a lot of forcing moves, so I really don't have that many liberties. For instance, that means he can pull this out, so this is kind of a forcing move. If I do this, that's just terrible. So that means he can pull this one, so I need to, so he's going to get that move for free, and he's actually going to be able to get an eye here. If I poke here, he still has this. So he now has an eye, so it's eye versus eye, and he's going to win no matter what. So, I am going to do this. I'm going to see if I can profit the best I can from this capturing race. You decide capture. You're actually going to have two eyes out right now. Which is interesting. But I do not think the game is over yet, even though I lost this big group. Because that is basically your only points. If I block you here... Are you going to start the capturing race? Like, if I poke in here, you just... Well, if I go here and do this... No, well, I can go here and then this. Or if you just block, I can Atari. Oh, you're going to do that. Okay, cool. So this group is alive, but I wasn't debating that at all. This protects a couple points. This protects more. So I'm going to do this one. And now there's this push through and cut, so I will, can I do this? I think I'll back off here. Like I said, there is this push and cut sort of thing. Okay, I guess we're gonna do that now. But I don't really care. So you're defending your corner. This is Sente, so let's take the Sente move now. Get as many of these points as we can. There is this descent that's also in Sente. And then this attachment? Is it Sente? Atari. Oh, man, there might be something here. Push. There might be some interesting things here. If you just back off, then I can back off. That'll be nice. If you try to fight, I can go here. And then if you Atari, I can Atari and connect. You now are alive in the corner, but then I can do a move like this. Well, let's see. There is this jump. I can get this in Sente, so I might as well take it now. So this is outright alive. I can save these for cold threats, of course. With two moves, I can live with this move and... actually, no, I can't. Can I? Because he has this point, so that's a false eye anyways. Which one's better? Probably this, I guess. Although, if I get a move like this... I think this whole cutting sequence thing works. So I'm just going to descend here for... Sensei points. He's not going to let me have it, though. Is that going to cut this off? If I go here and this, you go here. Are you gonna try to cut this off? Just trapezoidal shape, I think. Okay, you are gonna do that. Well, they're both basically alive anyways. I don't really care too much. So you're connecting, that's fine. Does this do anything? No. Well, it does kill a couple points. This... I really want this to work. Can we do this? And then I do this? Because then... After that, this... It's not Atari yet. If I go here... Can I do this? He'll just cover, right? Oh, KGS is trying to log off. Alright. I mean, like I said, there's still some... Like, I can now go here. Actually, I can go all the way to here and basically reduce this entire corner a certain amount of points. I can also do this one with the Sente follow-up and just take the points and then take the monkey jump. Just reduce him so that his only points are right here, and then I'm basically ahead, right? I mean, there is still some reductions. Like, he can go here, he can capture this one for 2 points, he can push me here, but I've basically got all that. I've got all this. So I think I'm going to just play good endgame, and then I should be fine. Because there's still a lot I do with this stone that he needs to deal with. Okay, so let's just take Sente moves again. This is now a Sente move later, of course. Okay, he's going to fix that way. I can actually do this in Sente, but I think I'll save it. And take... Monkey jump? Is there any other Sente points that I can do? It's not really. This doesn't actually get me any points, so I'm going to take the... what else can you do? He already has a stone here, which is kind of concerning. Monkey jump. He can just block. I can Atari. He can extend and then dead. So I'm going to monkey jump. Just play good endgame. Play good endgame. Alright, so you're going to do that. So I will... block? Do I care? If he Ataris, if you go again, that's not Atari. I think I can get more points with this, can't I? You can block. Can I jump? Can I go here? I can, actually. You need to respond. Otherwise, I can Atari. So this does invoke a response, but I don't think it's a good response. If I go here, can I throw in and... No. What's a good endgame point, I guess? Which next point, question. This goes to that. If he doesn't respond, I can cut this Atari, and then it's just dead. I'm running out of time again. I don't wanna lose again. If I push, then I have to pull back. However, there's some issues. So if I go, I'll just respond, I think. I will be nice and respond. So this is setting up that sort of thing, preventing, actually, you know what, yeah, preventing me from Atari-ing that sort of stuff. So I will, that's not really a point, this is a couple points, and it also exposes that cut. This does that too, but it's not really a thing anymore, so I'm just gonna go here, I think. I'll just defend, I guess. No, this is a curse of... Well, there's no points here. He can Atari and come back and Gote. That is exposing this, so I will do... connection here? Or this? This, I can actually do this then. So let's do this move. Not that I really need the eye shape, but... Okay, so we're finally doing that. Great. Yeah, so he's got a few points here. This is quite a few points, don't get me wrong. It is substantial. He's got 3 points in the center here. This is a point. It's not Atari, so I'm good. This is worth 2 points. I think you should have captured this instead. It would have been bigger. If I don't respond, I can do it here, and then he can Atari and get that point as well. I think either way, if I connect here, I'm better off. Because then if he does that, this is now sent to any hill response. I'll just do this. If I do that, then he can capture and maybe start some shenanigans with that coal thing. So we got this borderline here yet. There's a borderline here. This is double Gote. This is now... Uh-huh. This... Does that save me a point? This one saves me a point. This one also saves me a point. This one saves me 2 points. I think this is bigger. Is there anything else that's worth points? Like, I can poke in here. Because if he goes here, I have to do this. Yep. That's setting up a snapback. That's just Atari. That's just Atari. Yep, okay. Those are all forced. So this is pretty much settled then. This, I am going to respond this way. Because I can Atari and... This also threatens to... Well, this actually gets rid of the point. Because then I can go here. If he goes here, I can take the point here. So that destroys the point here. If he tries wedging, I can Atari and connect. So I will take the point. Now eventually he's going to have to fill that, of course. He's going to push immediately. So now I took Sente back from him. From there, there isn't any points here. That's not a point. Is this a point? This is a point. Because he needs to connect before Atari-ing. And if he gets... This is a point. Okay. Is there any other points? Any other bigger points? That's 1 point. 1 point. This is also 1 point. So let's just take that one. Yep. Now this is setting up that. If I go here, he can get this Atari. But then I can push through here. I think this is more efficient. Rather than just connect. Although there isn't any points there, so I'll just connect. So that this is not Sente to connect here. I can now push in here and get rid of that point as well. Actually I can do this now. Which Atari and go here and it's alive, so maybe not. There isn't any points because I can go from either side of and he needs too many moves in order to get anything in there. This is a point for me though. Because he pushes in here, that this is a point. This is 2 points in Gote. This is worth 1 point. This is actually bigger now. So let's take this. Oh, that's interesting. Oh, you know what? Well, that's Gote actually. So this is also 2 points in Gote. I misread this one. This was 2 points in Gote. I can now Get this. That goes to that, though. I don't want to do that. If I do this one, though. Oh, that's interesting. I'm going to do this, I think. So there basically isn't any points in the middle at all. If I go here, there is this cut and this Atari, but this Atari doesn't go into anything. So this is separating that, which means that this is now Sente later. Although I need to... it's actually Gote, but it's actually really dummy. That's all it is, isn't it? Because there wasn't any points here. So that's just dummy then. This is eventually going to be a thing, which will force me to do that. This is, yeah, Sente. I can now connect here and push. That doesn't do anything, though. Does it? I will have to eventually do this. Can I do this? No. What about this? Does this work? Let's see, if he goes here... Well, hold on. If he pushes, I can't Atari, so I can go this. If he goes here, then I can connect. If he connects, that's... Then I can go here. And then, I can go here? And, oh, you know what? This is kind of interesting, actually. So this is threatening to set up this Atari. I shouldn't have done this without taking this liberty first. Okay, so you're just connecting. So this is Atari, and then I can connect. Actually, I can poke here. So I can Atari first. And then I connect. And then if he goes there, then I'm just done. So I have to poke here. If he goes here... Then I have to come down and go here. If he follows me again, that's just I can capture. So I need to poke. But this liberty is going to be important in this shortage thing. So you are just going to connect. Okay, well then I can Atari and go here. Actually, I can Atari and go here, except if you could do this. Atari and go here. I'm not sure how this is going to work, if it's going to work. Okay, let's see. The point is, or the idea is trying to get an eye. And he's got an eye here by going here. I can Atari and go here. And then there's push and push co thing, right? If he goes here, I can Hane and go here, capture, connect, make two eyes. So I need to do something like this, I think. If he makes an eye, then I can make an eye. No, I can't, actually. So you think he's shaking in his boots, or did you read all this out and say, it's not going to work? So you are going to push directly, okay? Well, the idea is that if you capture, then I can... Well, I can pull this back, right? And you push, and I go here. Actually, if... it's going to be no eye versus no eye, and this is going to be Seki, right? Because if you capture, I can... if I go here and you capture, I can go here. If you extend, I go here. Actually, then you'd have to do this. I need to take this so that you can do this. And then I can do this. If you capture, I can... Nope, you're going to have an eye here. Damn it. So if I go here, you just make an eye. Okay. What else could I have done? Could I have just gone there directly and then thrown in? No, because I need to make an eye over here. So he had me eye to make the eye. So he's just going to do that, huh? So if I do this, he makes an eye. Yeah, he's gonna make an eye. Okay, so that doesn't work. This is eventually gonna have to happen. This is also eventually gonna have to happen, so... while I think about that... Let's do this, because this is eventually gonna have to happen. And likewise with connecting there. So if I just take this now... I'm thinking... This is not Atari. He can take a liberty and force Atari. Nope, he's going to connect. Alright, what if I connect here? He makes an eye. If I go here, I can then throw in or capture back. But then he just makes an eye. I capture, he cuts. So, one big territory versus three medium-sized territories. What is this, 15 points? Two, four, six, eight, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20 points here. 7 points here. 2, 4, 6, 8, 7 points here. 2, 4, 6 points here. 3 points there. So that's 10, 16, 26, 36, plus this. Is there anything else? Is there anything else? Let's see if I connect, he can push. Going to pass. Okay. So I don't think I'm that far behind, although he does get Comey. That is one thing I wasn't remembering. Ah, that's dead. So... 28 and a half points. Okay. Yeah, so that these medium-sized groups weren't big enough. I want to look, though, because I'm curious if he was the same of one as before, because he opened very similarly. Game records? Nope. It was another weird first, last, initial. Lost by time. I'm very sad about that. This one I will review, though. Because this one actually went to completion. So, yeah. Maybe, well, okay. The reason I didn't want to do this and set up my orthodox is that it's... I mean, this is the bigger side, and he's going to get to approach first. So maybe I should have done this first. And did my orthodox that way. The last few games, I didn't get to play Orthodox. That the one that I did was that, let me go back. I think it was this one. Did that work? Review? Oh, here we go. Okay. Yeah, this is the one that he quit right away. Why isn't my scroll button working? Okay, there we go. He quit after whatever move this is, so I didn't really get to play it. But the two ones that actually went a long way, aside from the one that I did on time, I didn't actually play Orthodox. And this is bad. I really think he gets this extension. And this is probably not the right response to this. This kills this enclosure, because this enclosure wants to extend this way, and this is just being way too nice on him. I think I probably should have approached. And even if he gets something like that, maybe that would be better. I don't know. That I wasn't really happy with. Yeah, this was not good for white, given the influence. I just failed to use it. And this, I did not want to play this move. I actually wanted to play this move. That way, when he plays here, it's not sente, and then I can take this and do something else. I can take my extension then or something. When I go here, I need to respond. Otherwise, white will get this Atari, and then... Or, I mean, I think I would respond. I don't think Atari in this way would be very good. So, yeah, this was a misplay. This is the one I was reading and the one I wanted to play. And take the extension. So, anyways, I decided to invade. This is a strange move. I thought he'd do this. And when he would do that, I could potentially. I mean, I was hoping for the rush invasion, of course. So that I could attack the single stone here. And if he tries covering, I can get all of the hanes. And then this stone's in the right spot. If he tries cutting first, eventually he needs to come back and fix some way. But then again, this stone is still in a very good spot for him. Or in a bad spot for him to use. Plus I can then go here and peep at it and worst case pull back or even like this. This has no shape and it's gonna go straight into the stuff. So that's what I was expecting. What did he end up playing? Oh, it's already covered on top. And just let me. Maybe I should have Hane'd. Because then if he does this, then I could kill that. I think the cut might have been an overplay. At least for what I wanted. I still wanted to maintain connection with this. Letting him turn here. Maybe Atari. Then if he captures, I can go here. Because then I'm connected to everything. This isn't such a big deal because I can just Atari and go here. Oh, there's a double Atari then. I do this one. If he tries extending, I can just follow. Because this doesn't go to a ladder. If he goes straight up again and then comes down, is that a problem? Like I can destroy the eye, I can destroy this eye, I can turn here. Yeah, okay, so yeah, you probably end up doing this and then coming back. So if he'd go here, I'd probably just pull back. And then if he wants to cut the stone off, this is already killed anyways. And I'm giving a lot of influence now. But then I can still come back and expose this cut. This is now alive on the side, and I own all of this. If he tries pincering, I can poke through and cut. Or cut, probably this way. These are not going to live. How do I deal with this? Mean, just like. Yeah, they're. Ooh, maybe there's a problem here. Those aren't strong enough to do that. What about this then? Then I don't care. Because it only has one eye, and then this stuff is. Yeah, okay. That's what I was hoping to do. After he. What did he do? He did this. With the cut. Oh yeah, when you cover on the top, that's what I was hoping to do with this cut. I was hoping to maintain connection with this. Okay, so took an extension here. This submarine invasion I don't think is good. Maybe I should have done this in response. I was worried about this whole cutting sequence though. Like usual though, maybe I shouldn't be because there is this thing. And then I can cut here to get the eyes if I need. Yeah, so this cut is kind of a problem. Actually, you know what? No, maybe it's not. Because if I just go here, worst case, I come back and do that. And then these stones are still without a base. These are now even shorter of liberties. Clamp. No, that's not a problem. You know what? Maybe I shouldn't have been afraid of this cart. Now, I'm still in Q land and that sort of thing. And so when I see a knight's move cut, I always expect this to be the initial response and then cut. But oftentimes, and it's starting to come up more and more, so I really need to just kind of unwrite this move and add this move of just backing off. Yes, you can push again and cut, but this is a lot more manageable cut. Because after this, what is he going to do? Worst case, I do this. Does he start running out some more? But then I can keep the attack on, or even well, no. If I come back and defend, like I'm afraid or something, let's say I don't though, and he takes that point. What happens if I do this? Like he can't cut that off if he tries doing this. I have this, and now this is Mii for eyes. He's not getting any eyes. If he takes this one, I can take this one. If he pulls back, I'll have to do this one, of course, or capture. He, of course, can get a couple moves and... No, it's not going to work. Yeah, I overestimated that cut, which allowed him to get the two eyes in the corner. And then this is just running free, so this is kind of a wasted move at that point. Since he went over here, I probably should have done this then. And even if it was just incremental like this, I'm still able to attack from this side and this side. So him building up influence here is not a big deal. And even if we do this whole thing, it's a lot better for me. Oops. Because, yes, this looks really big. But, you know, I still can jump it from here. I still can even possibly use some cutting stuff. So, yeah, this ceiling in is too late at this point. It's alive. This is alive. So that's not good. And then this. Yeah, this is too small. Definitely. Instead of that, take a free move and then connect. This is still floating. You'll need to do, I don't know. And then I can push through and threaten this. And then still come here and cap it. Again, this is still free move eventually. This is the weaker one. Or however this is going. So many, many big mistakes like that. Saving the cut in stone, so at least there's still... And again, he doesn't respond, which is inconsistent, I think. So he spends his sente to come back here, and then I threaten to cut it off, and then he ignores it. And then this, yeah, this being able to connect is also a big pain. Maybe this would have been better. I have more control over the connection, and now he has two separate groups. I probably connect with this, but then I can disconnect this one again. And then this does become a running fight again. That was interesting. Force the cut. So maybe I should have just Atari'd this way? I was greedy. That was definitely greed, though. Atari. Assuming he comes back and it connects. So maybe I should have done this. This ladder was a trap. He laid a trap for me. This is a trap. Yes, he knows those stones are going to get caught in the ladder, but he wants... Huh. So I should have done this. And defended the cut, then. There's still this cut. Maybe I should defend this cut. Well, it kind of reverts, doesn't it? So it doesn't really help. This cut is still a problem. Huh. Yeah, so a couple free moves. See, this. I think in order for the whole group to live, I needed to let these two go. I needed to do this and this. And then with those two, yeah, because they're both sente against both of these things. So I should have taken those first and then come back and done this if I really wanted it. Because now I think I'm alive, aren't I? Because he can't throw in here. He has to go here, but then that's two eyes. This move is key right here. So, yeah, moral of the story, instead of responding to this one directly, I needed to take the sente move. Because without it, this thing's going to die. And now I can cut here and have two eyes. If he does, let's see, if he tries pushing and then defending, does it help? No, because I can still cut here. Oh, but then there's this again. But then at least I'm out, I guess. That was something else I was kind of considering. Wait, I'm not even on the main line. Here we go. Instead of just do this, Scene captures, I can connect out. This effectively seals it in though. I then have a ton of cutting points, and then I can... Then this group is a lot smaller than it was. I mean, it's still going to turn into that running fight thing. I just think I might have had a better advantage with that. So even with those, I still wasn't... because you would push through here and poke up here. Or would I ignore that? Would I just cut? And then he connects out. I lose this. I can force this. That doesn't help, though. Because he would just come back in Atari, and then all that's gone. But then I went lose this, right? Yeah, so... Yeah, so even with this Sentai move, he doesn't have to respond. Because if he does this... Well, I'd hear, maybe. No, because he can cut that. Because that's Atari, and then it's just dead. He just had way too many liberties. And then it's just endgame at that point, just trying to get as much points as I can. Now, my endgame, I think, was definitely a lot better than his, and I recovered quite a few points in the endgame. I was going to look at this. So I hide here, but what I was saying before is if I do this, then he can... Well, he can't capture, but he can do this. If he starts taking liberties, and this is where that outside liberty is important, because then I can throw in here. This is Atari, though, so he still wins the capturing, as it looks like. I versus no eye, very important. What else can we do? Well, the throw in to take the eye is important. What about here? He'd have to play here first, but it's still I versus no eye. However, hold on, wait. This, that. Yeah. Can you ever take that last liberty? That's pretty much it. So yeah, technically three games. Oh man, does it show? Late at night. Well, I mean, yeah, it's 7:30, but for me, it's late at night to play these games. So hopefully the weekend or hopefully the games we play this weekend will be a little more in my favor with a full amount of energy. That's kind of the unfortunate thing about doing it late at night after work. It's like completely mentally drained coming home. Quit making excuses for losing somebody. Yes, I know. I'm still very heartbroken about the time loss. I think that would have been a really interesting game, but I spent way too much time with a few stones, and it ended up being a couple seconds of stone, and I just couldn't play him fast enough. And that's kind of the one big drawback about Canadian Boyomi, is that I can't spend 10 minutes in the opening trying to figure out what I want to do, and trying to figure out what direction I want to go, where I spent all that time, that is. So we're going to end that here. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you guys liked the video, please like it. If you're new around here, subscribe. And if you have any questions, comments, suggestions, or feedback, please feel free to leave them below. Thanks again so much for watching, and we'll see you guys in the next video.